Hello everyone. In today's session, we will explore how to develop a model-based Power App. For this, we need to log in first to the portal of Power Apps, the development area. In my previous video, I have also explained how to secure an environment where you can play around and develop and test various tools on Power Platform. So since I'm already having that environment, so I will just log in, and the dashboard is shown here in front of you. There is, you know, various data sources available, and then there are various apps available. First is important is environment. The environment is nothing, a container having multiple objects, and then on left hand side there is a solutions section where you can create your own solution. And basically solution is a container or a grouping of various objects. So in that solution you need to also create a publisher. Publisher is nobody but a developer or a creator who has created that app. So I need to prefix also, provide a prefix so that all the objects in this solution, whenever I create, so it automatically prefix with my own abbreviation or you know, prefix. I need to also provide contact information. This is optional, so it is always a good idea to whatever piece of information you want to disclose, that can be also included. So once I have created the publisher, then I can select the publisher, and version numbers are also mentioned. Whenever you will be creating the next version, so that will need to be updated. So now the solution is created inside the solutions section. On the left hand side, you can see various section itself, which I have explained also in my previous video. So just I need to click the create button and then create a new table. So basically we are targeting a project management app. And in that project management app, first of all, we need to define our data structure. You can see I'm creating a table, and this title field is nothing, just an index field or a primary key field. And also I need to enable the attachments. And this is a very important step. When you have, for each of the record, there are attachments, multiple documents which you can attach. So just after the wizard of table creation, it will take a while, and then columns will be shown in front of you. So it the table has already provisioned. I can create my own custom fields then. Basically this is a description field. I will need three tables basically. One is task, one is activity, one is project. So project record will have multiple tasks, and every single task will have multiple activities. In this way I need to model my project management app. So the status field is also very important, like what is the status of my current task. It can be new, in progress, close, or completed. So close is after completed, means key user has already verified if something is related with project management or task. So closed will be after verification. So these are various you know, choices. So multiple data types are available for each of the field which you will be creating. You can also define default values. So I will be quickly creating all the fields in order to save time. And priority is also important for a task. So again I will choose choice data type. And in choice, I need to also provide multiple values for my choices. For example, priority can be top, urgent, urgent, medium, and low. So there are various types of, you know, field data types are available. This is similar to the SharePoint list, where you can define multiple fields. And it is also similar to an SQL Server table, where you can define field extending from multiple data types. Each field will have single data type. So in this way, description, status, priority, and also the key user validation. Once a task is completed, so key user has to verify and then it need to be closed. So he can the key user can either verify through email or phone. The verification is very important step in order to close the task. So basically, I'm after table all the tables are created, then I need to interlink those tables which through the relationships. It is same like entity relationship diagram in database when you have primary and foreign key relationship. So in similar way, we can have, you know, lookup field in SharePoint list. In similar way, we need to interlink those tables. So there are certain tables which are already provided when you create an environment. In Dataverse, multiple sample tables are already provided. And you can also make use of those tables and you can create your own custom tables. So as long as I'm creating now, you can see data types which I have created. That is also grouped in my solution. So solution is a grouping and it makes your life easy when everything are grouped inside a solution. And it's similar like Visual Studio solution where you can have multiple projects or a project in which you can have multiple objects, similar to that. So there will be another table called activity. In that one also I'm enabling attachment and key field is again title. And one single task can have multiple activities. So there is one to many relationship between task and PM activity. There is project management activity. And almost similar fields I need to create here. So there will be a display name and a name, of course, a technical name. And so the description will have a text box type of, you know, interface. And then status, now I can select choice and my previous status which I created during task field creation is now already exists, so I can choose that one and yeah, this one, and it will show me all the same values which I have inputted last time. So default value will always be new whenever you know new activity is created. So duration is also important, and duration field is already available in hours. So I can make use of that one. Sorry. There are already pre-existing fields. Whenever you create a table, so those fields are already created for making your life easy so that you don't have to keep track of versioning and multiple other things. So lastly, we will be creating a project table. Project will have multiple tasks, so it will be one to many relationship between a single project to its tasks. So, and then account is already pre-existing table. Account means a customer. So just give a name to the projects table and also display name for primary name column, which is title. Again, I will enable attachment. Then I will, meanwhile, I will create other fields until the pre-existing sample fields are populated. So in order to save time, start date, and I will make use of data type of date. There is a date and time, but I need only date here. And then end date, when project will be closed. I will save the table. I will make this part shorter so that in next part I will brief about model driven app. So I will cover that in my next part of the video. So I will add an existing table called account and include all its components, means all related things, all related fields, field data types and anything. So just I need to now start making the relationship between the tables. So first start with account and go to the relationship tab and one to many relation and choose the foreign key table, which in our case is PM project. During naming, I did a mistake where I missed the prefix. So just let me go and delete the project table and let's create it again. Okay, first let me try to rename. Okay, so I'm in project table itself. Yeah, display name is available. So plural display name, and then but technical name is disabled here. So I think I need to recreate the table because I need to keep the technical name as well in a similar pattern. So yeah, the technical name is disabled here. So I'm just deleting the table because it's now does not contain any data, and in the early stages it is better to make everything final, everything perfect, so that later on it is, if some data is there or already we have established some of the relationships, then it's difficult to delete. Although you can delete somehow, but it's it will create dependencies. When you also create business process, flow and other things, business rules, then it definitely will create a problem. So just need to create the table. It's a small effort. Just let me do it quickly. I will enable the attachments and okay. Description field, text area, data type, which is more than text. It will give you a text box, start date and date only, data type, and then end date. I need to choose date only. Yeah, now let's start relationing the tables once again, starting from the foremost parent, that is account or customer account. I need to go to the table itself, then the relationship, create a new relationship, one to many, and then need to choose now the foreign key table, PM project, and the relationship name already given. Type of behavior can be multiple. Parental is always good. It will delete child records as well, but restrict delete, referential restricted delete is also available. When child records exist, so it will deny to delete the main parent record. And other also available, but mostly these two behavior are always good. So parental I will choose in order to make life easy, so that there is no orphaning of records. Now let's go to the PM project relationship again, one to many, from project to task. I will choose PM task. So now you know the prefixing of PM will help me organize the tables. So I will again choose parental here. I have prefixed all my tables like PM. PM means project management. Or project management app, so that will make my life easy in sorting whenever I'm picking in relationships or elsewhere. So my tables will be sorted in one place. Lastly, I will make a relationship from task to activities. See, in both way, when you create a relationship from parent to child, so child will also have opposite relationship, that is many to one. As in my case, I'm creating it one to many from parent to child. So child is also showing the same relationship. So means on both nodes, you will be seeing this one. So type of behavior parental again. Almost we are done, and all the objects, all the relationships are here, and all the objects are here in my solution itself. So let me check it. In the data node, you can create any records in that table. So just let me, for an example, let me enter a record. Guys, if you are liking my videos, please subscribe so that I can further create useful videos for the training purpose. Also, please provide your valuable feedback and comments. And I appreciate so many guys are subscribing to my channel, and thank you very much. So just let me create a customer XYZ phone number and website. A sample record. Let me save and close. Once this video is done, please tune into my next video. I will upload it quickly. So just let me refresh, and yeah, the record is there in my view, and all the objects are in this solution grouping. Thank you very much, guys.